So next in my series covering banned Pokemon episodes, we come to the...
Solve the clue, crack the code. Solve the clue, crack the code.
In the infamous Porygon Seizure episode. This was one of the most well-known controversies in Pokemon history, and really threatened to shut the whole show down in its early days. Today we're going to cover what happened and the lasting effects it had on Pokemon's history. It all happened in Japan on December 16th, 1997. It was the 38th episode of the new and incredibly popular Pokemon anime series titled Computer Warrior Porygon, or more commonly known as Electric Soldier Porygon. Kids and families gathered around their television sets and eagerly watched as the anime showcased for the first time on screen the Pokemon Porygon. For the majority of the episode, all was well. It's actually a pretty goofy and unique episode that sees Ash and friends get sucked into hyperspace to try to stop a virus that Team Rocket has set up inside the Pokeball transport system. The group is aided by Porygon, who can transform and use a variety of techniques inside the cyber realm. While inside the Pokeball transport system, Ash and the gang are attacked by an antivirus program that shoots missiles at them, mistaking them for the virus. Ash and the group fly away on a Porygon as Pikachu destroys the missiles with a thunderbolt. And just as this happens, a strobe of colors and lights flash on the screen to show the explosion of the missiles. As millions of Japanese families crowded close to their television sets to watch the show, these strobe effects trigger a massive reaction of symptoms in the viewers, including epileptic seizures, vomiting, and irritated eyes. Over 700 Japanese people ranging from ages 3 to 58 were reported to experience these effects from the broadcast. The episode was immediately pulled from broadcast and banned from any commercial release. The Pokemon anime was then put on hold. The entire production went into panic and rumors of cancellation swirled. After some careful planning and damage control, the show set up to resume airing after 4 months of hiatus. Before the series restarted, a special report was aired on April 11, 1998, titled Anime Pocket Monsters Problem Inspection Report. In addition, an explanation aimed for children was shown on the first episode after the incident. The original version of the episode has never been shown again, except by mistake on Hulu Japan. OLM also responded by dropping strobe effects from Pikachu's electric attacks. For years following the incident, a disclaimer was broadcast at the beginning of all Japanese television shows, cautioning viewers not to sit too close to the television, and to watch only in a brightly lit room. To avoid further controversy involving the episode's central plot, Porygon has never had an important role in another episode since, despite Pikachu being the one who actually caused the explosions. Porygon's evolved form, Porygon 2 and Porygon Z, have also never been shown in the anime except for the 15th movie, which even in that situation was only a cameo. Porygon itself has also made a cameo appearance in the first four films and a chancy operation. This moment became so well known worldwide that several popular shows have referenced it over time. The Simpsons parodied it in the episode 30 Minutes Over Tokyo, and South Park in the episode Chin Pokemon. It even made it into the Guinness World Book of Records for the most photosensitive epileptic seizures caused by a television show, which has to be one of the most random world records ever. The episode can be found several places online, and I've actually watched it for myself without any issues, but I'm sure that if someone has issues with bright flashing lights, you should probably avoid watching it. If you watch the show on Netflix or buy the DVD set, you'll notice the missing episode in the order. So now you'll know why there's no number 38 in there. As insane as this moment is in the grand scheme of things, it's actually kind of sad that Porygon has basically been completely removed from the anime. I really like Porygon, and it's one of the original 151 Pokemon that started it all. All I hope is that someday they decide to give it another chance and a fresh start. Do you think Porygon will ever appear in the anime again? Let me know in the comments below and tell me if you've seen the episode or not. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so we can keep making Pokemon content, and as always, we'll see you next time.